Happy Monday! Does this entrance look familiar to you? Yes, I'm at Calvary KMC. Why? Because today is Monday of Holy Week! Yesterday, we celebrated Palm Sunday, entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. For this Holy Week, Calvary's Education Ministry will post one video each day until Good Friday for us to follow footsteps of Jesus. Now, let's go inside to learn more about what Jesus did on Monday of Holy Week. Alright, here we are. Alright, let's say hi to Pastor Bo.
Hi.
Alright, and here's Pastor Heron.
Hi guys.
Hello, hello. And that's it, right? No, we have Pastor Gil. Hello.
Oh, good to see you guys.
Hello, hello, hello. All right. So you might be wondering by now why we are all here, especially on Monday, right? Before I tell you, let's figure out what Jesus did on Monday of Holy Week. We are going to look at Matthew chapter 21, verse 12 and 13. So if you have a Bible with you, please open Matthew chapter 21, verse 12 and 13. It says, Jesus entered the temple courts and drove out all who were buying and selling there. He overturned the tables of the money changers and the benches of those selling doves. It is written, he said to them, my house will be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a den of robbers. So just like Jesus cleansed the temple right after he entered Jerusalem on Monday, today, Pastor Gil, Pastor Heron, Pastor Bo, and I, we are going to clean our places of worship, which are Shalom Chapel, Daniel Chapel, and Vision Chapel. So if you're ready, let's get started. Question. Start with Shalom Chapel. Here we are, Daniel Chapel. All right, let's get started again. Maybe we should start with the vision first. That is the biggest one. Vision! Oh! Apparently, this is new. Alright, Let's get started again. I'm so glad that we got to clean Shalom, Daniel, and Vision Chapels today. Since it's been almost a month for us to get all together to worship, chapels were a bit dusty. Before we move on any further, I want us to take a moment to think about the meaning of Jesus cleansing the temple. During the time of Jesus, temple was a place where God dwelt, a place for people to connect with God. As you already know, perhaps, in the Old Testament, that place was called Tabernacle. I think Jesus' action of cleansing the temple challenged us to think about our perception toward places of worship and how to prepare those places. Due to Jesus' sacrificial death, the temple is no longer the only place of worship. We can worship God anywhere because God ultimately dwells in our hearts. Yet, having physical and tangible places of worship surely help us to remind ourselves to prepare our hearts for God. That is why we pastors cleaned Shalom, Daniel, and Vision Chapels today. Even though we cannot gather for Easter there physically, we wanted to prepare those places, rooms for God. And while we're cleaning those rooms, we could also prepare our hearts for Holy Week and the coming Easter. Therefore, today I would like to challenge you with two things. Why don't you take time to clean your own room? Lately, our homes have been places of worship. And while you're cleaning, I also want to challenge you to prepare your heart for Holy Week and coming Easter. Because once again, your heart is the ultimate place of worship. When you're done, if you want, no pressure, only if you want. Why don't you take a selfie? Or in Korean we say 인증샷. Take a 인증샷 and post on your social media, Instagram or Facebook, using hashtag CalvaryKUMC. If you don't have any of those accounts, Instagram or Facebook, you're more than welcome to send your picture to my church email account or to your pastor through KakaoTalk. Even though we cannot meet weekly together, I want us to remind ourselves that we're in this together as a community. As a community, I want us to prepare the death and resurrection of Jesus together. Sounds good? Good. Thank you so much for watching this video today. And please look forward to another video which will be posted tomorrow. Bye!